Hi, my name is Bob Zolo of Agilent Technologies. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to test a DC to DC converter in a better way using a new Agilent product. So the device under test here that I'll be demonstrating is this DC to DC converter. This is a 2.5 volt input, 3 volt output DC to DC converter. Now, typically when you would test a DC to DC converter, you need a whole pile of instruments. You need a power supply to source into the DC to DC converter. You need an electronic load on the output of the DC to DC converter. You need an oscilloscope. You need a voltmeter. You'd need some current shunts in order to measure current. Well, all of that equipment is replaced by the DC power analyzer and the modules that are installed inside it. So now you have a single integrated package, which allows for much faster setup and much easier testing. So this is the N6705B DC Power Analyzer. We have it configured with two modules. It's a modular system. Module 1 is an SMU module, the N6781 SMU, and module 2 is also an N6781 SMU. The first module, module 1, is going to be powering the input of the device under test, and the second module will be loading down the output of the device under test. And what we're going to be doing is a DC to DC startup test. So I have a block diagram of the system here. In the block diagram, you can see SMU number 1 is set to 2.5 volts constant voltage, and that'll be powering the DUT, the DC to DC converter. And SMU number 2 will be on the output of the DC to DC converter. It'll be set to draw 1 amp at 3.2 volts. So we're able to source and load the DC to DC converter. Now the test that we're actually going to be doing is a turn-on time test. So we're going to turn on the input side of the DC to DC converter and measure how long it takes for the power to come out of the DC to DC converter. And of course, that startup time is a critical measurement for anyone who's doing DC to DC converter design, because the faster it starts up, the more efficient it can be in its operation. I'm also going to be using some software to drive this instrument. The software is called the 14585 software, and that is used to use the large computer screen here to take care of the testing. So, let me begin by bringing up that software. And as you can see, it looks a lot like a scope trace. We are in oscilloscope mode. And you will see the traces of voltage and current appear on the screen in a few moments. Now, the first thing I'm going to do, I've preset everything. I'm going to turn on output number 2, which begins drawing current out of the device under test. But since there's no power being applied to it, it's just a load sitting on the output. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to arm the oscilloscope by pressing the scope button here. And now the scope is armed. When I push the on button on channel 1, that will apply power to the device under test, and that will also trigger the scope to make a measurement. So let me go ahead and turn that on. And you can see here now there are some scope traces. So let me describe what's on the screen here. So the DC power analyzer, channel 1, this trace is the voltage. And at T0, the voltage goes from 0 volts to 2.5 volts. So that's the power being applied to the device under test. The second trace here is the current being pulled out of channel 1. And you can see here at the time when the DC to DC converter power is applied, the current begins ramping up until the output is turned on. Now this is a unique capability of the DC power analyzer, the fact that it can measure current directly via a scope trace. Normally you would need a current shunt in order to measure current with an oscilloscope. But that measurement is built directly into the modules, hence simplifying the test setup. Now the green is channel 2, that's the output side, and what you'll see here is this is the voltage on the output, and when the converter finally comes on, you'll see the voltage jump up to 3.2 volts. So the turn-on test that we're going to conduct is to measure the difference between here, this point and this point, in order to measure how long it takes for the output to come on. Now I could do that the old style way by counting the grids. It's about 3 boxes and it's set to 10 milliseconds per division, so that's about 30 milliseconds. But like an oscilloscope, we have markers, so let's bring up the markers and make the measurement with the markers. So I turn this on, this brings up markers. Now I'll put marker number 1 on channel 1 where the power is applied. I'll put marker number 2 on channel 2 where the output finally comes up. And if I go right to here, I can read off of that 28.8 milliseconds, which is the startup time on this DC to DC converter. So as you can see, this measurement was very easy to do. It was just a simple matter of putting the markers on the traces, and all of that trace information came out of a single box called the DC Power Analyzer. Thank you.